Hi, I'm Peter Travers of Rolling Stone, and we're going to talk about movies, but we're just not going to talk about them in specifics. We're going to talk about the entire fall, and that means from Labor Day on to New Year's Eve, when all the movies that come out seriously want to win the Academy Award. Even the comedies want to win Academy Awards. This is what it's about. And I searched and searched for some kind of theme that would bring, unite this together. And you know what? All of these movies are incredibly violent. They're violent even past action. Sometimes they're violent because it's emotional violence. It's what we do when we behave with each other as families, as lovers, as anything. We really don't punch each other out, but we're thinking of punching each other out. And right away, we're going to get off to a kind of major start with a David Cronenberg movie called Eastern Promises. And this is set in London, and it's about the Russian mafia. And Viggo Mortensen is a driver for the Russian mob, and he's all tattooed. And there's this incredible scene, as there would be in any David Cronenberg movie, where brutality and beauty are always linked, where he's in a bathhouse, totally naked, all his tattoos, and two guys in suits with knives come to get him. And Viggo's jumping all over. I want to call that the balls out showstopper of the year in movies. So that's a killer movie, really good, you've got to see it. What else is out there that's violent? Well, there's, count them, six movies about Iraq or Afghanistan. Suddenly Hollywood has discovered what's going on and they're going to make movies about it. One of the early ones in September is called The Kingdom with Jamie Foxx and Jennifer Garner as FBI guys who go over to Iraq and try to find out about why there was a wholesale slaughter. And the movie's all boom, 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 action, action, action. Other movies like Paul Haggis's In the Valley of Elah, by the way, that's the valley where David slew Goliath with the slingshot. There's a metaphor here, so watch out for metaphors. But it's Tommy Lee Jones trying to find out how his soldier son was killed, not in Iraq, but when he was home on leave. Since it's Paul Haggis's first movie since Crash won the Oscar as Best Picture, it's that same kind of thing. Lots of characters, a mystery at the heart of it. Really, really interesting. Lions for Lambs comes later, where Tom Cruise, get this, is a senator. Meryl Streep is the journalist who is interviewing him about his senatorial policy towards Iraq. And Robert Redford, who directed it, is a professor who is trying to look at war from an academic standpoint. So I could tell already you're probably saying, I can't, how much of this can I take? I mean, Iraq, Afghanistan. Kite Runner, huge bestseller, is also out there. And Charlie Wilson's War with Tom Hanks and Julia Roberts, you're going to get a lot of this. So now you're saying to me, will I ever laugh? Is it possible for me to laugh? You're going to laugh twice, at least two that I know, because I've already seen them terrifically. Steve Carell, who we all love on The Office, and we love this, the 40-year-old virgin, is in a movie called Dan in Real Life, where he's kind of a loser, and he finally falls in love with Juliette Binoche. And what's the problem there? Juliette Binoche is the fiance of his brother, played by Dane Cook. Really smart, funny movie. But the big funny movie in a real There Will Be Blood way is called Margot at the Wedding, starring Nicole Kidman and Jennifer Jason Leigh as sisters. And Nicole Kidman has decided to go out to the Hamptons and attend her sister Jennifer Jason Leigh's wedding. All happy? Oh, not a bit of it. I mean, Jack Black is the guy who Jennifer Jason Leigh is going to marry. And these two sisters go at each other. This is from Noah Baumbach, who gave you The Squid and the Whale last year. And, oh, man, I've never seen a movie where no one really hits each other, where there's more blood on the floor. But you're going to laugh anyway. The laughs will just stick in your throat. And this is it. There's musicals as well out there. I mean, you've got Johnny Depp and Sweeney Todd, big Broadway musical, but what's it about? Johnny Depp is playing Sweeney Todd, the demon barber of Fleet Street. He's on a vengeance kick. He is going to get all the people who sent him to prison and get them in his barber chair, slit their throats, and he ships them off to Mrs. Lovett, played by Helena Bonham Carter, who, by the way, is the wife of Tim Burton, the director of Sweeney Todd. And she makes the bodies, the dead bodies, into little meat pies that she then sells. This is the musical. I mean, people, what is happening? That's the Christmas movie from Paramount and DreamWorks. The other musical that I think you're going to be fascinated by is called I'm Not There. And this is a movie from Todd Haynes about Bob Dylan. And he's come up with the idea that he's going to have six actors play Bob Dylan. And I'm not even going to spoil the surprise for you, except to say that Heath Ledger is one of the actors, Richard Gere is one of the actors, Christian Bale is one of the actors, and Cate Blanchett is one of the actors. Has Cate Blanchett ever struck you as Bob Dylan before? I'm here to tell you that she will. She plays him during his androgynous period where he was mad at everybody and he was going to change the world, and she wields that guitar like a weapon in the movie. I'm going to go out on a limb here and say that Cate Blanchett should win the Academy Award as Best Supporting Actress for I'm Not There. And she will then be the only person that ever has won two Oscars for playing Bob Dylan and Katharine Hepburn, as she did in The Aviator. I mean, we are in a freaky deaky fall. Right? Everything that is coming out in this fall is meant to whack us around and spit our head around six ways from Sunday. And the other major big movie, and this is another huge Oscar contender, two of them actually, I love both of them. The first one is from the Coen brothers, and it's called No Country for Old Men, from a novel by Cormac McCarthy, starring Tommy Lee Jones as a sheriff out west who has got a massacre on his hands, and Javier Bardem as the psycho. This guy, he can rank with Hannibal Lecter to me as one of the scariest people I've ever seen. I mean, he's a machine. He's walking out there with a cattle stun gun and killing people, or saying to them, toss a coin and we'll see what happens. This movie will scare you senseless, but it's brilliant. It has so much to offer in seeing it. Academy Award nomination for sure. The other one is Ridley Scott's American Gangster. This stars Russell Crowe as a cop. It's a true story, who in the 70s tried to bring to justice a drug kingpin from Harlem, played by Denzel Washington, giving what I think is his best screen performance. And since we know he's already won two Oscars, and I personally think that Denzel Washington is one of the best screen actors we have, for me to say, this is that kind of performance. He plays Frank Lucas, true character. We see him get heroin into this country through the coffins of soldiers who have come back from Vietnam. It's hard stuff, it's gritty stuff, and it's true stuff, and it works. So look at me. You're looking at me with a huge smile on my face because summer is over. I don't have to suffer through any more nanny diaries and the dregs of what summer had, and there's great stuff ahead. So you should look at what's in Rolling Stone, make a little list for yourself, and say, I'm going to the movies a lot this fall, and you're going to be happy.